Look, man, I'm serious, okay? I saw this with my own eyes.
Oh, I believe you, buddy. I believe you. Just tell us a story. Tell us a story.
Okay, well, it was last Friday night. I was walking home from the bar, and this woman started coming towards me. She was staggering, you know, so I figured she was drunk.
Whoa. Okay, tell us, be honest now. How many drinks did you have?
No, man, I barely had a buzz on.
Oh, come on.
Look, just listen, all right? She got closer, and I got a good look at her. You gotta see her eyes, her nose, her whole face. It looked like it was rotting.
Yeah.
She looked like a corpse. Like a walking corpse, man.
Sounds like my wife.
I've never seen anything like it. I haven't been able to sleep since that night.
All right, calm down, buddy. Calm down. Just, hey, you gotta stay strong, okay? Don't give in to fear out there, right?
Yeah, well, you got that right. If you freeze up around these things, they'll sink their teeth in you.
Just getting good. I need some sleep. Oh, shit!
I'm almost there. You know me, I'll be fine. Sounds good. I'll be back as soon as I find Chris. I will, but I gotta go. Why does everyone think I'm gonna get in trouble? What the? Thank you. Hello? Anybody here? Hello? Are you okay? Wait here. I'll check it out. Here.
You all right?
Yeah, I think so. Thanks.
You can thank me later, when we're safe.
Holy shit.
They'll have some answers at the police station.
Wait, you're a cop?
Yeah, Leon Kennedy. You are?
Claire. Claire Redfield.
Live around here?
No. I'm looking for my brother. He's a cop, too.
Well, It's a good thing we found each other. I don't know what to expect anymore.
Attention all citizens. Due to the citywide outbreak, you are advised to take shelter at the Raccoon City Police Station. Free food and medical supplies will be provided to everyone in need.
Oh my God, this is so unreal.
The police station's not much farther. They'll know something.
Yeah, but what if we're the only ones? What if there's no survivors?
No, there's survivors. Big city. There has to be. Looks like we're walking from here.
Okay?
Yeah, I'm all right. How about you?
I can't stay here. It's not safe.
Oh, shit. Go on ahead. I'll meet you at the station. Can't stop. Gotta keep moving. The end of the world.
police station. Almost there. Come on, Chris. Where are you? Oh, shit. They're inside, too.
David! Marvin! You there? I found a way out. It's in here. Send reinforcements! East hallway!
I should help this guy. turns a museum into a police station. Focus, Claire. Focus. God.
Open up! Hurry! Open up! Open this goddamn door!
Oh, shit.
Thanks.
Obviously, someone taught you well.
Yeah, I know how to take care of myself.
Come on.
So nobody knows what caused this?
There's a lot of theories, but all I know for sure is that this place is crawling with zombies.
Yeah, you're telling me.
Hey, keep that on, just in case.
I'm not gonna be around long. Once I find Chris, we're out of here.
You really Chris's sister?
Yeah. Why? Did you find something?
He's on vacation. Europe, I think. Left weeks ago.
Vacation? That's great news.
Well, I've got more for you. Looks like there might be a way out through this secret passageway.
Good. Hey. Hey, we should probably get you to a hospital.
Oh, forget about me. I can take care of myself.
No. Don't be ridiculous. You're gonna need some help.
Listen, Claire. Save yourself. So you can see your brother again. Now, you'll probably need this.
No, I'm not taking that. You're gonna...
Shh. And be careful. If you see one of those things, no matter who they were, you can't hesitate. Take them out if you can. Or you run.
Well, hello there, friends and Resident Evil freaks just like myself. The Belmont wants to welcome you to what is going to be my long, in-depth playthrough of Resident Evil 2. Glorious remake that it feels like a blessing to this unholy world of ours. Now, when I say in-depth, what I mean by it is that my intention is to build an episodic series, of course focus on both Leon and Claire's Redfield playthrough, while retaining the story and its lore thoroughly intact. But for that goal, I decide to keep my commentaries at minimum. It's been a formula that I've been sticking from some time ago, where it's all about adding some commentaries to your videos without breaking its immersion, without affecting the audio quality that a game can have, and without constantly distracting the viewer from the core experience of the game. So, this may be the only moment of this whole playthrough when I'm adding my voice over the game. Because I don't really want to be talking till your brain starts to bleed out. You know, I don't want to keep doing that mistake that many other streamers or Let's Players, they do. And what I'm trying to say is if I do commentaries, it's going to be a very partial thing. It's going to be only on certain moments of the game, in a very brief moments. That's all. You know, this game, it means a lot to me, and the fact that this remake exists, I really want to treat this game as serious as possible, because for the record, I am a huge Resident Evil lover since a long time ago. The first Resident Evil game that I ever played was called Veronica. That was the first time that I ever played a Resident Evil game myself. And I fell in love with the game. I totally love it. I love its characters. I love Claire Redfield and her brother, Chris Redfield. They easily became my two main favorite characters of the series. But then after I played Code Veronica, I played Resident Evil 2. Then I played 1. Then I played Resident Evil 3. So yeah, that's, you know, those are all my favorites from the old school ones. Of course, I also love Resident Evil 0. You know, after the remake, we got 0, which was a great game. And of course, I also have a huge appreciation for the most, you know, for the other more modern Resident Evil games like Resident Evil Revelations 1 and 2. I think those are great, underappreciated games. And also, I even like, you know, a lot of the combat and mechanics of Resident Evil 6. I mean, till this day, Resident Evil 6 has the best combat out of all the Resident Evil. Of course, it was more of a action, pure action direction that the game took. And a lot of people weren't okay with that. But I took it for what it was. And at least they were billions of times better than the stupid Hollywood movies of, you know, that they desecrated the name of the franchise. Now, about Resident Evil 7, sometimes people ask me why I don't love the game. And to be, like, frankly honest, I think the only reason why I don't say fuck that game is because they added the story of Chris in it, and because of the DLC of Chris, it was really good. Even if I don't agree exactly the way they changed him, it was awesome to have that DLC. He added a lot of value for me. So I brought the topic of Resident Evil 7 in reference of my worries of not having, again, a Resident Evil in third person. Because ever since after the game came out, I was hoping to get another Resident Evil that felt just like Revelations 1 and 2 felt. And then, well, you know, happened that I got blessed, because now we got this awesome remake and it's sticking back to the classic formula Resident Evil. To me, you know, I don't know, it's been featured that the soul of Resident Evil is third person. Of course, there have been many other first person games before, but, you know, it's not that I hate first person games. I would always prefer to see a game such this in third person. To me, it takes a hell of a lot more effort and work to make a good, balanced game in third person than first. It really does take a lot more work to do that. So I'm so happy that this game happened. Even if I know that Resident Evil 2 has a very simplistic combat in comparison to Resident Evil 6 or Resident Evil Revelations 2, you know, sadly we don't have those awesome stealth mechanics of Revelation. And we don't have that OP super action combat that 6 had. But I know Capcom, they're doing this for the reason to just keep the game more similar to how originally was. So they're trying to stick to the original formula of being just a little bit better than a battle tank, you know. Because it's really like the original Resident Evil 2, but with good camera angles and accurate shooting. So I'm totally happy with that, you know. I take the game for what it is, and I'm happy with it. Another thing I would like to bring up is that Resident Evil 2, it really reminds me also of one of my most beloved survival horror games of all time. And that one is called Alone in the Dark 4, The New Nightmare, where you play as Edward Carnby and, you know, his female companion, Eileen. So what it reminds me of is that it has that multiple way where you play with a male and a female, and they got this different, they're overall a different playthrough. But that is a quality that both of this game has, that it resembles each other so much. They not only had the same exact play style, the same formula, but it's something about the soul that these two games has that to me makes them so close to each other. And well, talking about the souls of things, one last thing I would like to bring up to this conversation is one of my favorite horror zombie apocalypse movie of all time. That is called The Return of the Living Dead 3. It's something about that movie and its characters and the environment that it really does feels like a Raccoon City movie. If you see it or if you have watched it, well, that's one of my favorite movies of all time. And also, it gives me that very, very strong Resident Evil 2 vibe, you know, like, of course, this movie, it came out before the game, if I'm not wrong. I'm pretty sure it came before Resident Evil 2. But still, I remember when I played Resident Evil 2, it made me think so much of this movie. Anyway, I had talked too much. You know, it's like enough talk. How about you? Let's play the game. Let's get immersed into this awesome game. And we're going to start with the Lady Redfield. Claire Redfield.